one.
Okay.
About how they did. Well done. It's good. It's a, you know, I looked at the thing and I felt like it was a difficult one. So well done. Okay. Like, you did really well.
Okay.
Like, in, like, portraying, you know, confidence and that. And, like, I, you know, just as, like, culturally, you'll be able to, like, come across, like, yeah, you just kind of had that presence that you, like, you felt confident, which is good. Like, if I was someone coming into that, I would want to kind of, like, I have all these problems and I want someone who's confident to be able to help me. So that's really good. So we did the first one's introduction and develop a collaborative relationship. And I think you did that really well because you really went through, like, why she was here, how you got the referral. And you said, like, I know this information about you because she's going to know, like, she's going to know you know this information, which I think is something people shy away from sometimes. And it actually, in thinking about it, it really helped because she didn't, you said, like, this is, I've had this information, like, you can read it, like, you can know about it, and it's this, this, and this, and these are the things I'm kind of, like, interested in, and the reasons why you're here, and I think that was really good, because you didn't let her kind of talk around the situation, like, you know, sometimes, it's like, in others, you kind of, they let her bring up the situation, but both have positives, and I think it's good, because you didn't, like, make her retell it that much of her story, I think, which was good.
Right, yeah, I just wasn't sure whether to introduce it myself, and I thought, look, I'm just going to introduce it up front.
I think it was, there can be positives and negatives to it, as there can be positives and negatives to the other way. And I think the positives were, she didn't have to, when you have clients with all this trauma, like, they're going to have to bring this up, like, a lot, and you didn't, that's really going to negate a lot of that, bringing it up a lot, and I do that in my own practice, where I know that our clients are going to have to tell their story a lot.
Yeah.
I kind of say, look, I know somebody, like, you know, I know. So I think that was really good. What else? And you debuted, so you said what your role is. You made it very clear, like, what your role is and what you could do, which is really good. And I think sometimes, like, she's coming with you with an issue, and she wants to know that you're going to be able to do something. And you really made that clear, so that was good. Inquire about the client's supports or relationships with extended family, neighbours, friends, work, school, agencies, which is really good. I think you inquired about extended and immediate relationships, which is good, but maybe in the future kind of see if there's any, and you did the GP as well, which is really good, and that's something that would probably be really important to her. And mentioned the mum. And something interesting is, like, the connection that they can have. That's something I liked that you did, like, connecting the two supports, one that might not be so good and one that might be good, but they're on equal setting, like, equal...
Yeah.
They have, like, an equal, like...
Status.
Yeah. Yeah, they have an equal status. Yeah. So that's good, and that's also, like, that someone's done, and I think that shows that you're kind of, like, problem-solving it a little bit. So there's lots of kind of problem-solving, which is good. Response to clients' emotions with genuine warmth and empathy. That was good, yeah. I'd say you definitely came across as, like, definitely warm and empathetic, like, your tone of voice, like, just your presence in the interview, like, that's really good. You weren't kind of focused on anything else. You can tell you're very involved. I'd say maybe a little bit task-orientated, a little bit, but not overly task-orientated. But it still shone through that you're empathetic and that you're warm. So that was good. Explore and work with strengths. I think this is one of the ones that a lot of people have difficulty with as well. So it's difficult to get into strengths really in depth in, like, 15 minutes.
I feel
kind of like, you know, it's difficult to kind of note on that. But you did really bring in strengths for the GP. You brought in strengths, like, that her strengths were her supports, I think. You brought in that with her mum, but, like, also at the end, just, like, you know, her being down on herself, you were just like, you know, you've done all this, like, you're a strong woman, like, you've come here and you're still, like, you kind of came across that you knew that she was feeling crap and, like, she was down on herself, but you're like, no, like, look what you've done, like, you've come here, you're a mum, like, and, like, kind of strengthening that mother like showing her strength in that is good as well. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Like, well, tell me if you. Yeah.
No. Cool. No. Yeah.
All right. Because I wanna be obviously giving you good information and feedback.
Yeah.
Inquires about and responds to client specific situations, like perfect. Because I think the difficulty in this is that it can turn into a bad situation quickly, possibly.
Yeah.
You know, and you, I knew you weren't skirting around the situation, because you felt uncomfortable. You weren't like, I didn't get the vibe at all that you were uncomfortable about the topic, which was really good. And I think that's the key to this, is that, you know, it's illegal and it can, like, it can turn into a bad situation quickly, and we don't want it to. And you know that she didn't want to, and you kind of like, you acknowledge that it's was about education and knowledge, and that's where it lied. I think maybe it could have gotten into a legality a bit too early. That would be only one thing that I'd note. But then you kind of draw it back to that. You do it because you know, in the readings it says, like, you acknowledge that she's kind of doing this because she loves her kids, and that kind of brought it back. So maybe legality is a bit too early, but you definitely responded to the specific situation. You knew what the specific situation was, and you knew that you had to do some kind of, like, mini risk assessment, which I think you did, and you made it clear that, you know, it's not, like, it needs to be reported on, which is good as well. So, yeah, that was good. So, do you know what I mean by, like, skirting around the situation, like, the actual topic?
You
didn't do that.
Yeah, what you mean, because I just addressed it.
Yeah, you addressed it, like, you're like, this is what we're talking about, like, and this is, she made, like, you know, you made it clear that we're talking about this and this situation, rather than you weren't uncomfortable about the topic. Which was good. Which is really good. And in that, you demonstrated cultural competency, that you were competent handling a difficult cultural, like, discussion. Like, it's difficult because, you know, being from, like, a white female perspective, like, you acknowledge that you don't know about this. Like, it's not your culture. Like, I'm curious, which is really good. Like, coming from a curious kind of questioning point of view is really good, because, you know, you're not coming as the expert into it, which is really good. You kind of put it, you're like, you want to know more about it, which is very good. So you recognise the cultural issue. You asked about it, you listened to it, and you started to explore some parts of that. And you said, I really want to know about it, which is good. Focus and direction, perfect. Good direction, good pace, matched the client's needs. I'd say it was smooth throughout, but maybe some awkward transitions, but that's, you know, to be expected. So it's fine. Don't take that badly. And you definitely set the stage for collaborative goal setting. So I don't think collaborative goal setting can happen directly in 15 minutes, but you set the stage for it, which is what it says. You were very directive in what the goal, the plan would be, which is good, but maybe explore a little bit more what she might think the plan might be. That would be good in the future. But still, she would have come out of it knowing that there was a plan, which is good. Which I think, as a client with an issue, it's something you want. And in your situation, you can provide it. Sometimes in other situations, you can't provide it, because it'd be more of a sounding board. So that's good. That was a good one. And identifies the presenting problem in context. So you address the presenting problem and the presenting situation, and you acknowledged it was cultural. You acknowledged that it's difficult. Like, you acknowledge that this is a difficult, like, cultural issue that is not going to be, that has lots of things to do with it, and maybe this needs to working out and needs education and knowledge for the for the mother-in-law. So I think that was good. You definitely put it in its context, and that it was not with her. I think I think that came across in the interview, that it was yeah, the problem wasn't with her. It was it's like deep seated, like it's cultural. It's going to be difficult to work out. Which was really good.
Mm.
Yeah. Do you have any questions? Like, do you have anything for me? You did really well. It was good.
No, I suppose it's they're funny, these interviews, because you just, like, you know you've got such a short amount of time, and you're just trying to go, right, have I covered that, have I done that, and so it kind of pushes you to, so I was thinking, to be more directive, because you don't trust to sort of just go, all right, I'm just going to really sit here with you, and I'm going to really get this stuff from you, because it's a false situation, you know, but
it is, and I think it's a difficult scenario in that it has strong legal ramifications. But then it also, there's that rapport building that needs to be done as well, and I think that's a difficult thing to manage, but I think you did really well, and like you kept the flow going. Like, it's not like, you know, you're directive, but that didn't mean that your empathy wasn't there still.
Yeah,
I think that still came through.
Yeah, okay.
Which is good. You can be directive and also empathetic at the same time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's difficult to manage all that kind of stuff.
And I've just been sort of reading about, working with involuntary clients, and just that whole balance of using a strengths-based approach with someone in that sort of situation. It's sort of like a really interesting kind of, I mean, this is totally different.
Yeah,
but
it's good.
You know, it's just kind of, you know, I mean, when you say that, I do think that I didn't give enough time for rapport.
You know, I wouldn't beat yourself up about that. Mm. And it's like interesting with, it comes down to this like sensitive position we're in as social workers, is that we have this half, like, legal, part that we have to us, and then this other, you know, part of us that has to be empathetic and rapport building, where those two things sometimes really clash against each other. So just, like, that is difficult just to sit with and think about.
Yeah, just that's where those two things meet. Yeah. It's a really interesting thing, isn't it?
Yeah. I work with involuntary clients as well, and it is, like, it's a difficult situation to be in, and that you can build rapport, and then it's always going to be that difficult.
Yeah. I'm sure people do it. I'm sure people manage it, and it's a real skill that you develop and that you...
I think it's something that everyone's always working on, and it's always going to be different depending on the clients.
Yeah.
Like, it really is.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Just acknowledging that, like, it's a different role, because it's, like, a difficult job. So, you did well.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very
That's
much.
That's okay. Awesome. Okay. So if you pop that off.